So I got a new app on my phone the other day.
It's like a voice recorder thing.
It was really helpful for tonight, for practicing and things like that. But I made a very startling discovery. So I was listening back from one of my recordings and I was just thinking to myself, who is this dweeb I'm listening to now? Because I realized my voice doesn't sound exactly the way I think it does. I don't know if anyone else feels like that, but like in my head I got this kind of, hey man, how's it going? Yo baby, what's up? Kind of voice. But in reality I'm like, I got a new app on my phone the other day. So yeah, so it doesn't really work out the way, and I think it's fine, like, you know, I don't really have to record myself that often, so I don't really hear it that much, so it's fine, but like, kind of, I remember you used to have to set your voicemail. Oh, geez. I used to take about 15 goes, and I'd end up with something insane that says like, hey, it's Kyle here, I'm not here right now, or something like that. It doesn't make any sense. But yeah, and I just love the way they're so like, what's the word? They're just so subtle about telling you. They're not going to come out and tell you, that's a bit shit, mate. They just say, yes, do you want to listen back to what you just recorded? Or else the second option is like, let's just try one more time. And then it's the third option, which is like, okay, fine. If you really want to go with that, go on. But it doesn't really matter anyway anymore because nobody uses their voicemails except for, like, actually, I get like two types of voicemails. One is from my friends, which is just the sound of the phone hanging up. So I don't know why, it's like in my head I just imagine going, okay, is this still the phone thing? I don't know. So like, okay, the beep's coming. I don't know why people do that. Then the other one is from parents. I don't know, people, their parents still leave voicemails. Like normally people get the message, you know, you're leaving a thing saying, I'm not here, leave a message, I'll get back to you. Your parents hear that as, I'm not here. But if you want to have the conversation anyway, go ahead. So, you know, you'll get one from your mom or something. She's like, hi, Kyle. It's 12:30. They're supposed to hear from you when I open it. It's already open. I know. But my favorite, I got married recently. Thank you. So I have a father-in-law now. And he's from America, and he's from Texas, and he leaves the best voicemails I've ever heard in my life. Because he leaves voicemails for my wife that have way too much information in them. So he'll start out every time and say, hey Lindsay, this is your dad. Tim Griffin. It's about 8 p.m. here, so... what time is it there? Hang on, I'm gonna Google it. Or shit like that. Shit like that. But yeah, he's a great guy, and he was over recently, and he's one of these guys that, very opposite to me, that he just never thinks about what he says. So we were out at a family occasion, and my brother went up to him. Like, my brother hasn't seen him for like 2 years. And normally, like, you go, yeah, a little exchange, a bit of, hey, how are you? He goes up, he's like, hey, Tim, how's it going? Tim straight away just goes, I forgot your name. So I don't know, that's true, yeah. Yeah, I have the opposite effect. I try and make sure I say the right thing every single time, and it works out none of the time. So, like, you know, you kind of, like, if someone's approaching in the hall, you're like, okay, just say something cool, say something normal. I was recently going to an event, I was meeting up with an old friend. She's not a friend of mine, she's an ex-girlfriend, but as I said, I'm married, so it's okay that we're still friends. There's no feelings there anymore. Like, we're not still in love with each other. But anyway, so, you know, I'm waiting, like, it's at her house, I'm knocking on the door, I see her coming, I'm just thinking, just say something normal. Hey, how's it going? What's crack? What's the story? Whatever. Say one of these things, you know? Door opens. How's the story? Fucking hell. And it happened recently again. I was at a friend's gig. A friend from work, right? He's putting on this gig. And, like, you know, they're awkward at the best of times. You know, when you're there, you get a text off someone saying, hey, I'm doing this gig. Usually on a midweek, usually in the workman's. Oh, okay. So you know. So at the end of the gig, I was like, okay, you know how this conversation is going to go. Just go up, say something normal, and then leave. So I went up to him and said, Ollie, I gotta go. I have to go give someone a lift home. And he goes, okay, cool. Thanks for coming. And instead of saying what I should have said, I finished what I thought you should have said. So I said to him, appreciate it. So, yeah, so that's how it was said. He just said thanks, and I gave him a direct fucking order. So, yeah. That ex-girlfriend stuff was going to bite me on the ass. So I realised my wife is here tonight. She's sitting there with Tim Griffin.